Inevitably, technology marches forward. We are living longer, healthier, and stronger lives. Reducing childhood mortality, bacterial infections, and improved hygiene have all contributed to this trend. However, with more people reaching their older years, more fundamental age-related diseases are leveling out how long people can live for. Dementia, immune system weakening, and cardiovascular problems are just some of the common occurrences of old age. Today, we will be focusing on cardiovascular disease and the development of the total artificial heart, or the TAH for short. Just what is it, and what does the future hold for combating heart disease? As of this video, cardiovascular diseases are the number one cause of death worldwide. 17.9 million people die each year from cardiovascular-related complications. 80% of these deaths are due to a heart attack or stroke. Any technology that could either heal or replace a heart would be life-saving. For now, we will focus on the replacing of the heart and address healing it in future videos. A total artificial heart is a device that is capable of completely replacing the function of the heart. The total artificial heart is distinct from a ventricular assist device, as a ventricular assist device is a pump that supports or replaces heart function and is attached to the heart. A total artificial heart, on the other hand, completely replaces the heart in the body, taking over all heart function. Among the earliest mentions of an artificial heart came from Julian Jean Caesar Lagois in 1812, when he postulated on the creation of a mechanical circulatory support device. Practical development of the artificial heart began in 1937, where a Soviet scientist called Vladimir Demikov successfully transplanted an artificial heart into a dog, which survived for 5.5 hours post-surgery. In 1957, Dr. Willem Kolff, a prominent name in the history of developing artificial organs, began his experiments implanting artificial hearts into dogs. The first successful trial led to the dog surviving for 90 minutes. While this time seemed small, Kolff was very determined to create a total artificial heart. From 1973 to 1981, the survival time of animals implanted with artificial hearts increased from 30 days to 268 days. In 1971, Kolff hired Dr. Robert Jarvik, who, under Kolff, would develop the first total artificial heart to be implanted in a human. The device was named Jarvik 7, as Kolff liked to name the devices after those who were working on it. The first human implanted with Jarvik 7 was Barney Clark, who survived with the device for 112 days. However, earlier versions of the device required patients to remain in hospital, as the total artificial heart remained powered by an external 180 kilogram machine. Other factors that contributed to this short survival time for the earliest recipients of the device included the fact that external pumps pushed air into the heart, meaning that infectious agents had an easy way to cross inside the body. In one study, among the most common complications included bleeding, infection, and strokes. Interestingly, device malfunction was found to be a very rare occurrence. Survival rates for the total artificial heart increased in 2010 when a portable version was developed, allowing patients to leave hospital. With this greater freedom, patients were no longer confined to a bed, could get exercise, socialize, and do almost anything that a normal person would, but still needed to charge their heart, roughly around every 3 hours. A 2014 overview on the development of this device placed survival rates at 86% for the first year implanted, and dropped into 64% after 5 years with the heart. As of this video, only one total artificial heart is currently approved by the FDA. It is called the Syncardia Temporary Total Artificial Heart and has been used for several hundred collective patient years of use. The device works through two chambers that fill with blood and two air sacs that expand to push the blood out of the chambers throughout the body. Despite only one model being on the market, what does the future hold for artificial hearts? One total artificial heart model being developed by a company called Carmat is aiming to evolve these devices from a fixed heart rate to a smart heart rate, changing based on the internal needs of the person. Such a device could lower the heart rate when a patient is at rest and increase during periods of activity. Another development in research is soft artificial hearts made of flexible polymers and being more heart-shaped. With solid heart designs, blood clots are more likely to form, so creating a soft, artificial beating heart could potentially help with this problem, and the more heart-shaped design could fit more naturally into the body, with the aim being to make one that lasts a lifetime. So, The future of artificial hearts could be a soft, beating heart that mimics a real human heart. Such devices could become more optimized over time, potentially one day becoming even more efficient than natural hearts. The development of the total artificial heart has come a long way, and there is still much progress to be made. What developments would you like to see take place with the total artificial heart? Leave a comment below, and thanks for watching.